The most common procedure performed for atrial fibrillation is a procedure called catheter ablation. Catheter ablation is based on a fancy IV placed in the groin that allow us to place catheters in critical places in the heart and effectively eliminate the triggers of atrial fibrillation. There are two different ways this can be done. There's point heating, also called radio frequency ablation, and there's also balloon-based freezing. One might not know that either heating tissue to a high enough temperature or cooling tissue to a low enough temperature can form a scar and eliminate arrhythmias. So catheter ablation is effectively a minimally invasive procedure. A lot of patients use the term surgery, but really is not a surgery. There's no incisions, there's no suturing. Ultimately, it's based on a type of IV in the groin that allows us to then access the vein, which then gives us passage into the inferior vena cava in the right atrium and ultimately the other chambers of the heart as needed. One of the things that we really try to educate patients on is, you know, how do we do this? One, we just basically place what we call sheaths. Sheaths are little fancy IVs roughly where the inguinal crease is in the vein there, which then gives us a conduit to place catheters in the heart. The catheters themselves are directed manually from the groin with both x-rays, also called fluoroscopy, and really the exciting thing in our field is also electroanatomic three-dimensional mapping. It's a big word, but ultimately it's a variant of GPS where we can see where we're moving catheters in three dimensions just based on a magnet placed in reference on your back. The nice thing about that is obviously it's three-dimensional as opposed to two-dimensional, which is what x-rays are, and also there's no inherent risk to three-dimensional mapping because we're not using radiation. Three-dimensional mapping really helps us see where we're moving in three dimensions without needing to use x-rays or other modalities. Ultimately, we're looking at both the anatomy when we do these procedures, but also, believe it or not, your heart has an electrical system that you can actually see, and as such, the endpoint is more of an electrical endpoint than an anatomic endpoint, although to help get you where you need to be electrically, the anatomy and seeing that is very, very, very helpful, if not essential. So one of the questions we often get is, how long are these procedures? Start to finish, they're roughly 3 to 4 hours. They can be a half hour longer, a half hour shorter, but ultimately I think 3 to 4 hours is kind of the sweet spot.